In this video, we are going to discuss classification of systems based on stability. In so many topics, we discussed classification of systems. According to stability also, we can classify systems. So, here is the classification of systems based on stability. Based on stability, systems are classified into three types. That is, absolutely stable system, unstable system, conditionally stable system. So, here absolutely stable system is, this is the system which gets a stable output for variation of its parameters. That means, for all variation of its parameters, it is going to get the finite output. So, then the system is said to be absolutely stable system. That means, for example, if you are having like this system response like this. If your parameter is t, varying parameter is t. If you are increasing this parameter from 0 to infinity also, your output or response of the system is finite, then you can say that is absolutely stable system. For all variation of its parameters, if you are going to get the finite output, then you can say that system is absolutely stable system. For example, if you are having unstable system. So, what is meant by unstable system means, generally whatever the definition for unstable system is there, that we will give here also. So, if you are giving finite input or if your parameter is going to vary, for all variation of parameter, if the output is not bounded or output is not finite, then you can say that is unstable system. For all variation of your system parameters, so if your output is not bounded or finite, then we can say that system is unstable system. Coming to conditionally stable system. So, the example for unstable system is, if my system parameter is t, my system function is going to vary with t. So, here 0 to infinity, my response of the system is like this, like a ramp. This is not finite. As I already told you that ramp is not a bounded signal. So, here for variation of its parameters, it is not going to get the finite output. So, we can say this type of system with this type of response is unstable system. So, coming to conditionally stable system. So, conditionally stable system will provide finite response in the limited period of parameter variance. So, here with the changing parameter, that means with all variations of its parameter, if the system is having finite output for limited duration, then we can say that is conditionally stable system. After that condition, the system may be stable or unstable. The system may be unstable. After that specific condition, system is going to provide unbounded output. For parameter variation, for all its parameter variation, for example, if the system parameters are going to vary from 0 to infinity, if your system is producing finite output for the limited duration of that variation, then you can say that is conditionally stable system. After that condition, after that limited period, your system may be producing unbounded output. So, after that condition, so you may have unstable system. So, here conditionally stable system means, so for the variation of parameter, for all variation of its parameters, if your system is producing finite output for the limited period, then you can say that is conditionally stable system in that particular limitations or limits. So, coming to techniques used to calculate stability. So, we are having so many techniques. Up to now we discussed so many definitions for stability and we discussed how to notice a system is stable, unstable or marginally stable according to pole zero plot, and like that we discussed about the stability. So how we can calculate the stability mathematically means we are having so many techniques. The techniques used to calculate stability are Rothhard's criterion and root locus, Bode plot, Nyquist plot and Nicholas chart. All these are the very important five techniques to calculate the stability of the system. So in this topic of stability, we are going to discuss Rothhard's criterion, which is very, very important in gate point of view. So the Roth matrix is very important. So if you know how to write that Roth matrix, then that is very easy to calculate the stability or any other parameters given.